So here's our special stop on this trip through Houston, Electronic Parts Warehouse. It's going to be another in my series of stops at old style electronic surplus stores. Going to add it to my collection. And we're going to go in and we're going to do a little shopping, looking around, a little filming, and then get back on the road. Interesting. Huh. Well, it's small, but there's a lot of stuff packed in here. And there's a few things I need, so I hope I can find them here. Huh. Wow. Yeah, it is small, but it's packed. It's gears. Wow, gears and sprockets. Cool. It's like a Rector set stuff. Or Meccano. Wow. I may have to make this place a regular stop on my cross-country trips. Motors. Wow. I mean, it's packed all the way up to the ceiling. Holy cow. It's motors, little motors, bigger motors down at the bottom. Great big motors over here. Kits all along the wall. Oh, this is just the first aisle. Books. Kinds of stuff. Wow. More motors. More motors. Not tubes. Or valves, for those of you British viewers in the British colonies. More books. More motors. More motors. Some sort of rack mount. FM stereo monitor. Oh yeah, old radio equipment. Cool. Foxhole radios, crystal radios. Lots of crystal radios, wow. More motors. More radio equipment, CB radios and stuff. Very cool. Very cool. HP 1630G logic analyzer. I'll bet that cost a pretty penny when it was new. Test equipment. Oh, look at this. Oscilloscopes. Enough oscilloscopes to choke a herd of elephants. Wow, including some really oldies down there. Now we're getting into stuff I might need. Yeah, I need some blank PC board. Let me go shopping in here. We got some single and double-sided PC boards material for experimenting with carving out the circuit boards on my CNC mill. We'll see how that goes. And, boy, there's all kinds of stuff here. Hey, here's a Tesla coil. Cool. lots of vintage stuff, microphones. Should I record my videos with a vintage microphone, maybe? Screws. Diodes. It's like IC chips and crystals. Fasteners. EEPROMs and EEPROMs. Too bad I don't need any. I got plenty. My retro computing projects, but I will look and see if there's anything here I can use. I don't have a lot of time here. I gotta get back on the road, but wow, I gotta explore this place. So we got 7-4 series, HC, LS, F, and just plain 7-4 series. Transistors. Oh my goodness. You know what? Oh, I wish I had the list of transistors I need for fixing the Spec 4 amplifier, although I've already ordered them. So hopefully they will arrive in a timely manner. Seven segment displays. Oh, and by the way, I just talked to one of the store employees. They are thrilled that I am filming and that this is going to be on YouTube. They can use the advertising. So yeah, they want to try and bring more people into places like this and keep it open. I'd rather shop here than like on Amazon or Alibaba any day, you know. Support people who run stores like this still. So quite a collection of model airplanes hanging from the ceiling too. And more vintage equipment up here. And so you got magnets. So all kinds of tchotchkes in this aisle. In this part of this aisle anyway. And a big keyboard. Lots of keyboards. There's just so much to see. It's packed floor to ceiling. More keyboards. More keyboards. And it looks like we've entered capacitor land. All kinds of capacitors. Both sides of the aisle. Excuse me. Oh yeah, definitely capacitor land here. IBM Wheelwriter 6. It's an oldie but a goodie. Oh, it goes back further here. Okay. I thought the store was a lot shallower than this. Okay. Looks like transformers and power supplies. Wall warts. All kinds of transformers and power supplies. Tube sockets. Yep. More power supplies. DC-DC converters. Oh my goodness. Yeah. I just bought some of these. For, powering my S100 box project. I need to hold off on buying stuff when I know in advance I'm coming to somewhere like this. Ah, potentiometers. Lots and lots of potentiometers and rheostats. Cool. And then fixed resistors, power resistors. And oh yeah, it is resistor city here. All kinds of tchotchkes over here. Okay. Security cameras.
Go ahead and scan your card over here on this side.
Okay. And you got the coax in there too?
Mm-hmm.
Awesome, thank you.
Terminal blocks. Switches. All kinds of switches, my goodness. And then they've got little displays up here explaining each type of switch. Very cool. Batteries. Oh man, I just bought a battery for my battery backup too. I gotta quit buying stuff when I know I'm coming to a place like this. Oh, extra credit if you know what movie this is from. Relays. Contactors. Power inverters. Oh, excuse me.
How are you?
Yes. Any help?
No, just shopping.
Okie dokie. I'll be all right, Jenny.
I'll holler if I can't find something. Oh, this looks like, yeah, look at this. This is the makings of a huge Tesla coil. This thing's gigantic. I put my hand in here for scale on the primary coil there, and look at the capacitor bank. Oh my goodness. That is a heck of a Tesla coil there. Wow. Tempting, but yeah. Another hobby I don't need to get into. We got here connectors and servos for RC servos. Molex connectors. Motion control made easy. Very cool. Optical encoders, circuit breakers, gotta have Arduinos, fuses. Let's see, plastic bags, bins full of plastic bags. Mosquito traps. Ah, edge connectors and, DIN connectors. All right, those, I better do some shopping here. Picked up a few odds and ends I think can help with the Teletech System Master project. Got enclosures over here. The way that I want to touch various connectors, audio connectors, video connectors, alligator clips. Oh yeah, and Banana Jackson plugs. I just had to buy some of those for my ATX benchtop power supply conversion project. So yeah, if only I'd known, I could have got them here. R2D2 or EPO. looks like power cords. Extension cords. All sorts of power accessories, lamp sockets, ballasts. remote controls. Apparently for everything under the sun. Wow. Audio cables, video cables, RF cables. Look at the dividers in their bins. Those are backplane boards. Or RF cable stuff and connectors, audio cables. Various odds and ends, teal balls. Mini jars, brown bottles. Ah, something else I can use. Could do some more shopping here. Got a few ring terminals I'm gonna need for a project. Stereo equipment, vintage stereo equipment. Lots of it. Wow. Lots and lots of it. It's like, you know, I really have no idea what that is. Digital mixer. Okay. Yeah, cool. Lots of stereo equipment. Oh, and here's computers. It's like speakers and audio transformers. Ooh, 45 records. Lots of 45s over there. And lots of LPs over here. $5 a piece. More speakers, lots of speakers, wow. On the wall over there. It's like telephone cable stuff. I don't know what this is. It's like a power supply. Telephone and power cable stuff over here. Well, there's a whole box full of motherboards. I get plenty of them already. I'm scrapping stuff out. World War II telephone. USB accessories. Flat screen TV, wow, that's an oldie. Seen better days. Whatever it was, power supply, I guess. Just all kinds of stuff in here. Patch cables. Wall plates of all sorts. Cat 6 cable, dual band, must be access points, yeah, access points, noise suppressors, mixing panels, yeah. My inner DJ out, that's a big mixing panel right there, wow. And it's like we got lots of fans and heat sinks in here. And what in the world are these? Betacam. Oh, wow. Betamax player. All kinds of weird format players that are long obsolete. But if you need one, well, you know where to go. Wow. More fans down here and blowers. Betacam. Sony. Ram sticks. I'm already up to my eyeballs in Ram sticks. I love the bin dividers. They're all PC boards of some sort everywhere. Adapters, cables, like video cables for computer, VGA, all kinds of adapters. Oh, watt-hour meters. And all kinds of meters. Oh my goodness. All kinds of components. It just goes on and on. How do they pack all this in this little building? It's so cramped in here, and it's just stacked to the ceiling, too. Wow. Okay, I'm going to stop filming and do a little actual shopping and see if I can buy a little bit of stuff from these folks and help keep them in business. Somehow I didn't even notice the vintage electronics magazines when I came in. Radio Electronics, QST, all kinds of stuff. Circuit Seller, you name it. Communications Quarterly. Wow. Good stuff. Good reading. Well, I would like to spend the day here, but I got to get back on the road. Long way to go yet, so I'm going to take one more quick scream up and down the aisles and see if I can grab a few more things, fill up my basket a little more, and then check out. All right, well, I got out of there for $107 and change. Got a lot of electronic components, a kit, a USB experimenter I/O kit that has all kinds of inputs and outputs for that plugs up to a USB port. I got some resistor networks. Whoa, there goes my receipt. It's windy here. Got some resistor networks, some ring terminals, some PC board material, and a really, really, really cool steampunk helmet that's going to out-steampunk a steampunk buddy of mine. So how do I look? Is it me? What do you think? Hey, Steve. Hey, Brad. You guys think you're steampunk? Hey, this is steampunk, okay? I think I got you beat. So, yeah, not bad for $107 and change. So, if you're in the Houston area, you got to check this place out. It's amazing. I wish I could have spent the day here because it's a small building, but it is packed solid from floor to ceiling. Lots of tight aisles in there. There's lots of stuff to see in there. You know, I could have walked out with easily twice this much if I'd had more time. So, yeah, check it out. Do your shopping here rather than online. Keep places like this in business. They need to survive. Places like this are dying really quickly all over the country. And we just got to support the ones that are still in business. They got really friendly and helpful people in there, too. Stop in and say hi. So, thanks for watching. I hope you found this video interesting, educational, inspirational. Whatever, give it a thumbs up, give it a like, come out and see these people. Subscribe to see my future videos. Press the little bell icon YouTube makes you press to be notified when new videos come out. So check out my second channel, ElectroGeek64, where some of the stuff I bought will show up there. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye. Okay, well that was a fun stop at Electronics Parts Outlet. I gotta get back here someday. If you're in the area, you definitely need to stop in and help support these people, keep them in business. So many of these electronics surplus stores are just going out of business all over the country. You know, one of my favorite ones in a previous video, Apache Reclamation is no more. So you gotta support them, keep them open. I was talking to the staff in there. They've had some struggles during COVID and just, you know, the online business is just, you know, killing them. So, yeah, come visit them, support them. And I got to find my way back to I-10 and continue my way west. And I have lingered here for a long time. It's going to put me behind schedule. So we'll see how far I get tonight. Okay, back on I-10, heading west again. It's almost 1 p.m. local time, so we'll see how far I get, because I am way behind schedule after that stop at Electronic Parts Outlet, but it was worth it. It was worth it. That was a lot of fun. I was talking to one of the ladies in there. I try not to film the employees or other customers when I do these sorts of things. But I was talking to the one of the ladies in there who worked there, and I told her I have a YouTube channel about electronics. And she said, oh, this must be like being in a candy store to you. And yes, it was like being in a candy store, exactly. So, so it was worth it. I don't care if I'm behind schedule, but just good to be moving west again.